be with you.
And with your spirit.
And that peace of God is what I wish for each and every one of you gathered for this Mass on the 12th Sunday of the year in St. Charles Luanga Parish Church. May all the prayer intentions, all our requests we have brought here in prayer be answered by our Father in heaven. He grant all of us the good desires of our hearts. To prepare ourselves for this Holy Mass, let us acknowledge our sins now and ask God, the Father of mercy, to forgive us. I confess, Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, in my thoughts and my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous faults. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord.
Almighty God, have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Thank you.
A reading from the book of Jeremiah, chapter 20, verses 10 to 13. Jeremiah said, I hear many whispering. Terror is on every side. Denounce him. Let us denounce him. Say all my familiar friends watching for my fall. Perhaps he will be deceived. Then we can overcome him and take our revenge on him. But the Lord is with me as a dread warrior. Therefore, my persecutors will stumble. They will not overcome me. They will be greatly shamed, for they will not succeed. Their eternal dishonor will never be forgotten. O Lord of hosts, who tests the righteous, who see the heart and the mind, let me see your vengeance upon them. For to you have I committed my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has delivered the life of the needy from the hands of evildoers. The word of the Lord. In your great mercy, answer me, O Lord. God-seeking hearts will revive. For the Lord listens to the needy and does not support his own in their chains. Let the heavens and the earth give him praise, the seas and everything that moves in them.
Are not two sparrows sold for a penny, But even the hairs of your head are all numbered. Fear not, therefore, you are of more value than many sparrows. So everyone who acknowledges me before men, I also will acknowledge before my Father who is in heaven. But whoever denies me before men, I also will deny before my Father who is in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
The increasing cases
A tender 3-month-old baby was said to have been raped last month. The Inspector General of Police disclosed recently that the police arrested 799 rape suspects between January and May this year. The rape culture is as repulsive and reprehensible as it is dehumanizing. Rape inflicts lifelong, untold psychological trauma on the victims. Rape is not only a grievously sinful act, but also a very barbaric and very criminal act. The case of a student of the University of Benin, Ms. Vera Waila Onozuwa, who on the 27th of May 2020 was reportedly raped and murdered by a non-resident, as well as other cases of rape and even gang rape, is a symptom of an ungodly and dysfunctional society. Our president, in his Democracy Day speech, expressed his displeasure on the recent rape and violence against women in the country, especially of very young girls. Recently, Pope Francis, very concerned with child abuse worldwide, on the 7th of May 2019, issued an apostolic letter in Latin, Vos Estis Lux Mundi, which means you are the light of the world, in which he acknowledged that the crimes of sexual abuse offend our Lord, cause physical, psychological, and spiritual damage to the victims, and harm the community of the faith. We in the Archdiocese of Abuja have formulated our policy for the safeguarding of minors and vulnerable persons in compliance with the directive of the Supreme Pontiff, and we have inaugurated a committee in this regard. While we call for prayers for victims of sexual crimes, we hope that the perpetrators of such heinous crimes will face the full wrath of the law, and hopefully they will be reformed. And through our prayers, hopefully, we hope they will also be delivered of the bad spirit that leads them to commit such horrible sexual crimes. Due to the righteous act of one man, Jesus Christ, his suffering and death on the cross, Christians have the capacity and are called to help to restore our sick world that has lost the sense of sin. Evil blinds us today such that we call what is bad, good, and what is good, bad. We try to put out the light of truth because it exposes corruption, dishonesty, oppression, lust, and many evils in the society. The remedy to evil is the fear of God, not the fear of men. To worship and honor God, to always tell the truth and shame the devil, and to acknowledge Jesus Christ before others. Those who stand up for Christ, in spite of the troubles, are the ones who will be rewarded at the end of time, when Jesus acknowledges them before his Father. Dear fellow worshippers, and dear fellow Nigerians, do not be afraid to speak out and to act against ungodly behaviors injustice, corruption, politics without morality in our country, that seems to be it. Politics doesn't seem to agree with morality. We have to pray and we have to speak strongly against that brand of politics that excludes morality. And if we exclude morality, that is why we have bad governance. We must learn to speak out, either by word of mouth or by our votes during elections. Young Jeremiah gave a prophetic message of doom to his fellow citizens at the time when Jerusalem was about to fall to the Chaldeans. Although this brought him hostility from the political and religious leaders, including his close friends, and Jeremiah was in prison, beaten up and thrown into the muddy cistern, he remained confident that the Lord, his mighty champion, would vindicate him in the end. Courage is speaker. That was what Jeremiah was known for. As Jesus says in the gospel reading today, even if we face fierce opposition and persecution or the danger of death, we should remain firm in the cause of right. Do not be afraid. Do not be afraid. That is what Jesus is telling us. Read Matthew chapter 10 as that one. John the Baptist was not afraid in telling the truth to King Herod, who took his brother's wife. When Peter and the apostles were brought before the council for preaching in the name of Christ, they said, "We must obey God rather than men." When Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego were faced with the option of bowing down to the golden image or risk being thrown into the furnace, they responded to King Nebuchadnezzar saying, "Our God, whom we serve, is able to deliver us from the fiery furnace. But if not, let it be known to you, O King, that we will not serve your gods or worship the golden image which you have set up." Go and read Daniel chapter 3, verses 17 to 18. Dear brothers and sisters, parishioners of St. Charles Kawanga, those of you present and those of you who are at home, apart from praying that we all remain healthy, and we should meticulously try to keep observing the health guidelines against COVID-19, I urge us to pray today. I urge us to pray today for the courage, for the strength and wisdom and knowledge to speak the truth of the gospel without fear or shame. Without fear or shame. To speak the truth of the gospel. This is the surest way of defeating evil. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Jesus Christ, the Lord of the world.
prayer of the faithful. The Lord listens to the needy. He is always ready with help that never fails. We have only to ask, so let us seek the compassion of the one who cherishes even the smallest sparrow. For the church, which dispenses the abundant free gift of divine grace, let us pray to the Lord. For nations enslaved by sinful systems of oppression and terror, let us pray to the Lord. For men and women who are tormented by fear and worry, let us pray to the Lord. For men and women discerning the call to be priests or religious, let us pray to the Lord. For those who have come into the presence of our Father, especially our loved ones, our parishioners, and those who have fallen to this pandemic, let us pray to the Lord. In silence, let us present our private intentions. We pray to Mary, our mother. Hail Mary.
and grant that cleansed by its action, we may make offering of a heart pleasing to you through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift your heart to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere we give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself and was born of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Remember my church spread through all the world, bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, our Archbishop Ignatius Kaigama, our Archbishop and Celebrant Memorial, our Emeritus John and our Mayor, all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who are falling asleep the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them in the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the blessed the Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs with eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin, and save from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world.
Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God,
me to invite the secretary to please come. The secretary to please come and welcome His Grace the Archbishop. You're welcome. We also thank all the secretaries of the Archbishop for your coming. May God be with you. Amen. As you go back, may the Almighty God go with you and grant you more grace in His vineyard through Christ our Lord. One heart.
Okay. All right. Thank you. That's a very nice anthem.
We're about to stay longer, but you know we are asked to conclude our mass
1 hour, so we don't want to preach the law too much. But I'm happy that we have been able to celebrate together a wonderful celebration. Thank you, Monsignor Madike, and your pastoral team for the good work you are doing here. Thank you all, and God bless you. And Father Alumuku was supposed to have said something about the Catholic television. There's no time for that. The summary is that I very highly desire that every household, every family, Catholic family in the Archdiocese of Abuja should have the decoder so that they can have the Catholic family in, Catholic television in their home, in their family. You will get more details. Monsignor will explain to you, and even Father Alumuku will be able to do so. It's important in these difficult times of social distancing and all that, the television can bring to your home the liturgy, catechesis, prayer, and all that, all that is going on in the Archdiocese. So please, every member of the Archdiocese, every family should endeavor to get a decoder to install the Catholic television in your home. This will bring progress, understanding, and harmony to the Archdiocese. As you go, I wish you a very wonderful and happy Sunday. God bless you all. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Blessed be the name of the Lord.
Now,
our help is in the name of the Lord. And Almighty
now.
God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. The Holy Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
And thank you, choir. Very well done. Thank you, all of you.
You are watching CTV